guys. Thanks for tuning in. So today's date is Monday, May the 23rd. Now, this day has been on my mind for probably about 2 months, ever since Swap gave me the call. So about 2 months ago, I got a call from Asian Dad, AKA Swap. He hit me up. He's like, "Hey, dude, you got a green card?" And I was like, "What?" He's like, "Oh, I'm just kidding. You got a passport?" And I was like, "Yeah." He's like, "Well, I know you're about to start working, but I need you to come with me to Spain so we can test out this new Stark Varg bike that was just released." And I was like, "Man, dude, I don't know if I could do it. I just started my new job. You know, I don't know how they're gonna be cool with letting me, you know, miss a week to go to Spain." So initially I declined it, and after that I talked to my mom, and she was like, "Dude, you're an idiot. What are you doing? Like, of course you're gonna go. You gotta go. Opportunities like this don't come every day." So I was like, "All right, cool, I'll figure it out." Worked it out with my scheduling. Got the scheduling cleared up to get to take this trip. So I'm super excited, man. I love traveling, and getting to do it with one of my good buddies, Don, is just an added plus. And on top of that, we're going to go ride this new bike, the Stark Varg, which has made some big noise in the motocross world over the past few months. So I'm really excited. We are headed right now to Don's house, and then I believe we're gonna get a ride from there to the airport. So trip to Spain is underway. So stay tuned.
Okay, we're on our way. We got our driver, Uber driver, Dahmer.
Got Renee with. What were you doing? You're losing track of time. You fall asleep?
I had two finals to finish before I could leave today.
Oh, he was doing an online EMT school. So we're running late.
I'm always late anyway, so.
But Dahmer's a big fan of the Fast and Furious movie series. We have a quick stop to make out Piston Bones Printing. Hopefully in and out. And on our way to LAX.
Okay, we're at Piston Bones. Jessica Papalaro, woman-owned business, making us some backgrounds for the Stark. That's a pretty good guess off of a picture, right?
Ryan, he's a genius.
Yeah, so Fox is sponsoring our trip to Spain, so we're throwing a little Fox hit on there. Thank you for always hooking us up.
Anytime.
And pistonbonesprinting.com.
Thank you.
Adios! Is it the same adios in Spain?
Yeah.
Is it?
We're gonna find out. I'm pretty sure though.
We had this debate if Mexican Spanish is the same as Spanish Spanish.
They're gonna be looking at me like, "What the hell is this retard saying?"
We made it.
Are you enjoying my international flight footwear?
Oh yeah.
Crocs.
There you go. But yeah, Dahmer got us here safely, and we're ready to go, so.
Successfully got checked in.
Dude, my green card worked, let's go.
We both got through with like 60 pound bags.
Yeah.
We were just nice to the lady and she let us slide.
So, security now. See if I can get through with all the metal in my body. And I got a lot of lithium batteries in my bag. GoPros, video cameras. I don't know.
We're getting on the plane. Gotta wear a mask for 11 hours. I thought COVID was gone for beforehand.
Yeah. So we made it. Just landed in Barcelona. We're about to start unloading. Looks like it's raining a little bit, but we're excited, so. So we made it. We're in Barcelona. Just picked up our bags. Asian Dad's tired.
We got no Mark Tilly though from Dirt Bike because he got COVID.
Oh, he's got the Rona. We're immune. We got it. We got to make it out here.
So I had that goofy red Jeep rental car in Boston. It was a lot better than that, I think. Pretty good upgrade. thing steers like a boat though compared to my van.
So Renee and I just checked into our room. It's always like this in Europe, dude. You get a room for two guys.
Hope you know I sleep butt naked,
dude. Oh, you sleep butt naked? Hey, just don't cross the gap. Don't mind the gap, bro.
Hey, don't cross the border, all right?
Yeah, a little crack. Oh, man. Room's not bad for... Oh, there's an ass washer. I thought for a second there was side-by-side toilets, but it's a bidet. And they got these like showers with no shower door. Half.
How do you use this thing?
Like that?
The hotel has a wine dispenser.
Really good, yeah. So he's cracking the whip.
I'm like six glasses deep. We're in Barcelona to test the Stark Varg. And Renee, they're talking about golf. They're talking about golf, not dirt bikes.
It's good to have
golf. Come on! It's good to have golf. They're still talking about golf.
Golf ball bandit.
Listen.
Saving money.
Dude, I got a picture of one of those guys working at the course.
Really?
Yeah, like literally like back.
I guess we're going golfing tomorrow.
Like 10 balls.
Renee and I were gonna go ride bicycles tomorrow on our free day.
I only just stopped losing balls.
I think we're going golfing.
It still happens, but it's yeah, that's like an actual achievement.
What are you talking about over there?
We're in Spain talking about golf.
Dude, because we're about to play golf tomorrow.
It's gonna be dope.
I'm gonna get more wine.
Another wine?
Yeah. Goes down like a California cooler. Bartles and James.
Oh my gosh.
Oh, now they're showing golf pictures.
No way, dude.
There's that dude that goes and picks him up. I literally have a picture of like a 10-foot crocodile in there.
Oh, wow.
Perfect. Hooking up with Aaron Colton.
Where are we
playing
at?
Playing golf in Barcelona.
It's like the best way to see where you are. You know, it's not the airport, it's not your hotel. It's like, this is actually where we are.
This is not the typical clubhouse look.
Definitely not.
Do we have to take our shoes off? So it turns out you have to have a license to play golf in Spain. We're unlicensed. So we rented a bag of clubs.
Because you need to get a golfing license to play golf here.
Yeah.
Which takes a 24-hour wait period after you file the paperwork and get it notarized. So we're at the range.
Range
time.
And hit balls. Share one bag of clubs.
Pro stuff. Okay.
See, when you haven't swung a golf club in 4 years, you gotta get it extra stretched out, huh?
Mm-hmm. I haven't done this in like over 2 years.
PGA bound.
Dude, this thing rips. Happy with that little baby cut coming back in.
I like it. So we've been cruising around, went to the range this morning. Now we're waiting to do this bicycle tour with Don. He wants to hold hands.
Barcelona city tour.
City tour. Pretty cool.
This Chinese chick is struggling. She's getting head shake. Head shake while she's climbing. Bro, let me brake check you.
You fucking ass.
You fucking ass.
I should have recorded that shit, did you?
Yeah.
Don't matter if it's a Roachy bike, we're on two wheels.
Little scooter guy trying to take us out.
Yeah,
God, dude.
What do you say? Wildest bike intro you've been to so far?
Oh, definitely. By far the coolest place. Pretty close to the top of the list of coolest places I've ever been in general.
Yeah. Yeah. We haven't even ridden the bike yet,
dude. I haven't ridden the bike yet. I've already been like, you know what, dude? This is already way cool. So.
Hey, well, you were skeptical yesterday when I said we're booking a bicycle tour home.
Yeah, dude, I thought we were going to do some janky shit. I was like, this guy's going to take us to the corner and we're going to freaking get robbed. I was like... But I remember you're like, dude, this is Spain, not Mexico. We're good.
It ends up being cool, huh?
Yeah, it was really cool. I
like rich chocolate cake. I can say it enough, but we really, really appreciate you guys coming out, and we'd like to give you a massive warm welcoming to all of you. We hope the trip is okay, and that you guys managed to get a little bit of rest before coming in. La tour inglese, perfecto, no? So, very, very quickly, coming through the gates, you've now started your experience with Start Future and your ride day with the bar. So, right now, I'm going to let you go and get changed. I've got changing rooms for you. If you need anything, Alpine Stars is here. Aero is up at the top. They're here if you need anything. Just FYI. And when you come out, we are going to mic you up, basically. So from the moment that you've come through the gates, all the way up until you get to see the Varg for the very, very first time, we want to capture all of that experience, your emotion. You're here today, and there are only 5 bikes riding. So you get that really close up, that small proximity with the bike, that personal touch. And we really want to capture all of that. Your emotions on the bike. You'll be riding also with a microphone, so literally if you want to scream, shout, or whatever, like please do, because that emotion that you're gonna get on the bike, we want to give to you, and we want you to take home with you.
It's like NFL. Are we supposed to shout? I was gonna say, me and Renee got best dressed, but Andy showed up in Fox too.
Well, matcha. I actually had matching boots to start with. I thought that was like a bridge too far.
here's a fit lit kit before we get out and get all muddy. Gotta go out and see what the guys are up to now. Here's our first lick of Stark Varg. This thing is insane. Right. Tell you what, we've been treated like kings ever since we got here. It's pretty sweet.
It's very difficult to repeat it with mud, you know, that's a good thing. So the motor which is here and the inverter is...
Yeah. Like you feel this is tacky. Stacky, and you're going to get some rot in there.
How do the ruts, I mean, are they the same? Like pretty, did the ruts develop similar?
on an electric bike, or is it different?
It could be different.
Because I mean, there is a difference between two-stroke rough and four-stroke rough.
So we haven't studied it at that point, because you know, Seb and Josh have been the only guys at that level riding the bike. Mm-hmm. So I mean, I don't recall seeing a different pattern, but I'm sure there is a different pattern. Yeah. It could be like you need to have 10 guys with electric bike and gas bike and see exactly the line. But
also, I don't want to give you too much information about the riding experience. I want you guys to tell me what do you feel, because I can bias you into one direction or another. So I'd rather keep quiet and let you experience it, then we can talk about it.
So, has anyone broken the phone with their helmet face yet?
No, it's a rugged military grade phone.
I'll do it.
Yeah. You're gonna go too thin now.
What do you think, Andy?
Really, I am.
I don't know what to think. Like, it's sleek and it's purpose built, and that's every component seems to be thought of. It's just such an assault, you don't know where to look first, kind of thing, huh?
Yeah. It's gonna be hard to ride after riding a Yamaha. Oh, because it's too Yamaha so wide.
Yeah. So slim, you know. But then again, bikes can be too slim, so that's gonna be interesting.
Is it, what is the setting right now?
In suspension, you mean?
Huh?
Suspension, you mean?
No.
It's 60 horsepower and the default engine brake.
How much engine brake?
I think it's 90.
90. Handles really well.
Yeah.
You obviously I'm casing stuff and it doesn't bounce like a.
It doesn't hurt.
Gas
like
box.
I know like a couple times I cased up and I was like, and I was like, oh wait, that was not bad.
You know, I didn't. I thought I would have more problem without the noise and the gears, but it makes the noise.
The traction, and the power,
Yeah.
But how?
It's kind of.
Do you notice like? The sound difference when you're on the side knobs of the tire, like it sounds more scoopy.
I'm not getting on the side knobs, bro. I don't know.
Tell me.
Holy shit.
How was it?
Dude, more than I ever imagined, you know?
Yeah.
Because I was really unimpressed with the Alta. I didn't care for that bike. And it's good to be the boss, because if we get one of these, I'm not letting anyone else ride. Okay, we're with Mark Sands, owner of MX Golf, and we met several years ago at Zaka Station.
Yeah.
So you're on holiday in the US?
Yeah, probably the next year I will go, probably.
Uh-huh. When you came to the US, was it just on holiday or was it to ride different tracks?
I rode different tracks. Mm-hmm. Yeah, loved the tracks of Cali.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Okay, so this course is laid out on an old golf course.
Yeah.
That's the name.
Yeah.
How long has the golf course been closed?
Now, 6 years ago.
Six years ago?
Yeah.
And how long ago did you get the idea, I want to put a motocross track.
When the Golf was closed, the first thing I have is, okay, making a IMX track.
Yeah, I think every motocross guy looks at golf courses and says, "Oh, could be fun, right?"
Yeah.
Yeah. How difficult was it to get permits? Like, do you own the land or you rent the land?
It's rent with option to buy.
Buy?
Yeah.
Uh-huh. So how many acres is this?
23 hectares.
23 acres. Yeah. And was it difficult to get permissions from the city?
Yeah. I have 6 years making permits, and it's long time, but it's at the final of the process, it's for my smile, and now it's have the permits and
yeah,
I'm good.
Wow.
It's my dream.
Yeah. I think that the layout is really nice. Elevation change, fun jumps, good dirt.
Yeah.
I think you did a good job.
Thanks. For me, it's a pleasure. Dan Don Maeda it's still here. it's a dream for me. Yeah, because I I love his work and love it.
Oh, thank you. Yeah. So we're here, and you know, is it pretty exciting that Stark chose your facility?
Yeah.
To exciting that Stark is using your track.
Yeah.
In the video, the launch video, it looks amazing.
Yeah.
But what is the plan for the track? Hopefully open to the public?
Yeah, in September it's 100% open for the public, three times a week, 4 hours this every day I open. And for the amateur guys, I think it's easy and so fun.
Yeah.
And for the likes, for the guys like me, I think it's perfect.
Yeah. How big is motocross participation in this area? Like, you know, California, where I live in Corona, so many dirt bikes, right? And in this area of Spain, how?
This area, now I think now the small kids, this it's making a good making a lot of people do. It's waking
interested,
up.
Yeah,
interested, but And I think it's different than Cali, because in California I think have a lot of people riding motocross. In here it's more popular, I think, enduro and trail bikes.
Okay, yeah.
But now motocross, I think in 5 years it's probably
gonna grow.
Yeah. Growing up. Yeah.
Cool. Well, hey, thank you for hosting us here. Yeah. I'm excited. Your track's amazing.
Yeah.
And hope to see you in California again.
Okay, thank you. Right. Thank you.
Thank you, Mark.
I love it.
A couple of bolts, you know, and just, it's like 7 bolts, I think, and it just slides off, and you replace the entire section.
Yeah, you just screw it on the seat base, so when you have to clean the bike or wherever,
it's
on off,
and I don't know why that is. Or
do you think, so it's in one bolt, not even two pieces this way, it's one big piece?
No, this one is one, but the front ones are one on one, it's separate.
Oh, okay, they're connected. Yeah. Okay.
And with the construction.
Hey, this ain't a bad first trip to Europe, huh?
Oh, dude, I've been spoiled. We've been spoiled ever since we got here, man, and it's gotten better every day.
Dude, right? The best part.
If mountain biking is sick tomorrow, I don't think I'm ever leaving. Sorry, Mom. I'm gonna extend my green card here.
trying to do another one.
I was almost. Oh man.
I want to see what he says.
Yeah, yeah.
Well, congratulations. You make riding dirt bike a little bit more fun, or a little bit more fun. Wow, I can't. That's crazy. I feel like I corner a million times better.
I mean, I was just saying to one of the other journalists that we can literally see from our side that when you're coming out of the corners, like,
there's just like no hesitation, no delay. Like, the bike corner is really good. Like, it's just when I lean it over, it stays lean. And even like, it's
a little bit hard to judge your speed when you're decelerating on this bike. Like those step downs, like one of them, I went flat. And like I said, I braced for the hard impact and it just...
When you're under tension and under braking, especially where there's bumps, you just feel the bike work. There's no extra like engine drag. So like, it just feels like you're almost skipping whoops. And instead of feeling like you're being thrown forward and having to push back, and then you're dealing with like the chassis tightening up because you're braking hard, it just like, it feels like the bike's just working and you're just there. Like it's so weird, it's unreal. That one was so fun because like now it's like, okay, I can see bounce things and I feel it's the same, like no problem. Like he said a couple of times, I started like hitting the jumps harder and pushing down on the faces, trying to like soak stuff up. And the bike's much more responsive. When you give it gas, it really levels out.
Okay, this is our drone footage. There's two jumps that I haven't done yet, but under the pressure of having a camera on me, I'm gonna just do them. First one is a triple out of this left turn. Triple, double, right-hand turn, downhill double. I haven't done that one yet. So, we'll see.
of this bike.
Do you have to censor it? Can we say what we want? Holy shit. I think we're both blown away. This is the most comfortable I've gotten on a new bike. This is the quickest I've gotten comfortable, and the most comfortable I've gotten on a new bike in a short amount of time. It's a completely different animal, but it was easy. It made riding easy. It allowed me to think about other things on the track and what I was doing.
I agree with Don 100%. I think the thing about this bike that was far more most impressive for me was just how easy I was able to adjust. I mean, with just 8 laps, I felt like I was able to take my riding to the close to the limit, and never once did I feel out of control or sketchy. I mean, it's hard to come into something like this and have expectations, but if I did, they were far blown away with just a few laps. I mean, I just honestly right now I'm not lost for words, and I'm just ready to go ride more.
Our hotel for tonight seems pretty baller. We're in downtown Barcelona. Let's check the view. I don't know if that works. All right, so Renee and I enjoying a little free time hard ride, huh? Dude, the streets in Spain are not made for a full-size car. But yeah, we are all done with the intro, and we're in Barcelona for a couple days, day and a half of free time. So we're going to this restaurant for tapas, which is a Spanish dish that Renee has not had yet.
Nope.
It's like basically a bunch of appetizers, like little stuff. But you're gonna fuck crack up on the name of this restaurant I chose, dude.
It's gonna be like Dick's Tapas.
You'll see. I feel like we're in the mean streets of Barcelona.
Yeah, we are. Huh?
Bartino. That ain't it. Gotta go around the street sweeper.
Oh, the destination is on your right.
There it is.
Arrived.
There it is. My fucking restaurant. Alright, so my fucking restaurant was closed. For the pizza.
So hot.
Well, half the lights weren't working. That's why I didn't know what it was.
Huh? The view from our hotel room is pretty cool. Be nicer if the window wasn't dirty. Yeah, we're where's the ocean? It's the ocean's to the left, huh? Can't see it. So breakfast bar is a little different in Spain, huh?
Just a tad bit. This is pretty luxury for me. Not quite used to it, if I'm being honest.
Salami. Beans.
No wonder why
it's made with an egg.
No wonder why Europeans are so much skinnier than the freaking Americans, dude.
Yeah. And, egg McMuffins. So we're going to rent mountain bikes today.
Yep.
And check out some trails, see if they compare to our skyline.
So I got the testing done yesterday on the Stark Varg. Today, me and Swap gonna go have a little bit of fun on the pedal bikes. Swap's parking seals are getting put to the absolute test here in Barcelona, because apparently everyone only drives fucking Fiats or smart cars. So, we've been having fun trying to find parking for our little Mercedes rental.
So this is Terra Bike Tours. Found them on Google. It's actually a pretty sick shop. I mean, there ain't no Roy Cyclery, but got a lot of stuff. They're a Canyon bike dealer. So we're running two Canyon e-bikes. Figure we keep the trip all electric. So, Kenny Roxon's teammate today. hardly a turbo lever. Okay, so we're finally on dirt. We rode like 5 miles through the city, climbed this wicked hill with the bikes turned off. Now that we're going down a little, you can tell this bike is a huge piece of shit. It feels like 32 millimeter forks on it.
So we did find the right trail. Let's see what we're in for. Should be fun. Ah, e-bike life is so nice. I said e-bike life is so nice.
So the nav from the bike shop is a piece of shit, and trail forks sucks. So we saw a hiker coming up this trail. It sticks. I think we're going down the wrong side of the mountain to get back to the bike shop. Pretty cool. What do you think, dude? Do you think this is animal trail or something?
And we'll find out. I'm gonna just fucking throw this bike in
the woods. Yeah, right. Yeah, fuck it, let's go. And there's a lot of trees that grab your bars. Yeah, yeah, yeah. Okay, this trail's not on trail forks either. I need some handguards. I can just hear Renee screaming. Really hope these plants aren't poisonous. Poison oak.
My arms are raw.
Oh, they're so itchy. My arms are so itchy right now. Oh.
My arms are red.
So this is, we came up this, huh?
Yeah. Was that something that we shouldn't have run into?
I don't know. I rode it pretty good after I crashed. But this feels like the road we came up.